Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see few tips and important topics with the help of which you can easily pass in AP Grammar Sachivalayam exam. So there are only 7 days left for AP Grammar Sachivalayam exam. So exams are going to be conducted on 1st September, 3rd September and 8th September. So there are different dates, different schedules for different exams. So on 1st September 2019 morning, Gram Panchayat exam, that is Panchayat Secretary exam, Women Ward exam and Welfare of Educational Secretary and Ward Administrative Secretary exams are going to be conducted on morning session of 1st September. And afternoon of 1st September, you'll be having exam for Panchayat Secretariat of Digital Assistant. And on 3rd, you'll be having exam of VRO, Ward Health Secretary and Survey Assistant. And also ANM. And coming to 4th September, you'll be having exam on Village Agriculture Secretary and Village Horticulture Secretary. Coming to 7th, you'll be having exam for Engineering Assistant and Ward Amenities Secretary. And coming to 8th, you'll be having exam on Ward Welfare and Development Secretary and Ward Planning and Regulation Secretary, as well as Ward Education and Data Processing Secretary. Now let's see how you can easily pass all these exams with few important topics and few important techniques. Let's begin our video now. So now let's see the subject wise. Okay, so coming to first, let's see what are the important details I can tell you regarding the exam of Agricultural Subordinate Services. Okay, so coming to Village Agriculture Assistant post, you'll be having Part A and Part B. Coming to Part A, you'll be having General Studies, and Part B, you'll be having Agricultural Subject. So coming to your syllabus of important questions, what you need to do is, you have to start preparing reasoning as well as quantitative aptitude and English for your Part A. Okay, in order to crack the Part A exam, here are the few techniques which I can tell you. Coming to Part A, you should be very good at your reasoning skills. Coming to the reasoning, you should concentrate on coding and decoding. Coding and decoding is very important, and seating arrangement is very important. Coding and decoding means, for example, they'll ask if bat is cat, then what is rat? Like this, like you need to decode. Okay, so this question, this kind of questions will be asked for coding and decoding. And then coming to reasoning, you should concentrate also on seating arrangements, which are very important. Seating arrangement is nothing but they'll be asking you a question such as, there are 6 people A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, out of these 6 people, B is sitting left side of A and D is sitting right side of F. So such kind of questions will be asked. Finally, they'll be asking you, who is sitting in the middle of the row, or who is sitting left side of C. So such kind of questions will be asked. Coming to seating arrangement, which is very easy, and also you need to prepare well in order to get easy marks and full marks. Coming to seating arrangement, so seating arrangement questions will be like basic questions. You need not worry at all. So as I said, coming to reasoning, please concentrate on coding and decoding as well as seating arrangement. Next important topic in reasoning is blood relations. Blood relations means A is mother of B, B is mother of F. How is A related to D? So such kind of logical questions, which correct explanation will be given, you need to think logically and find out the correct solution. Okay, So even blood relations are very important, and then you should concentrate on puzzle test. Okay, puzzles, they'll be giving you puzzles and you need to solve them. So these are also having high weightage coming to reasoning, and then you need to concentrate on series problems. Okay, series problems means they'll give you particular series and they'll be asking you what is the wrong number in the series, or they may also ask such as what is the next number which you which comes in the series. Okay, for example, let's take an example of a series. Okay, how they will ask you is 2, 4, 6, 8 dash. Okay, after 8, what is the number which may appear in the series, which is 10. Okay, after 8, 10, because see, you can find the difference of each and every number in the series with 2. Okay, 2, 4, 6, 8 dash. So 2, 4, difference is 2. Okay, 4, 6, difference is 2, like this. So such very, very basic questions will not be asked. Medium level of difficulty will be maintained coming to series questions. And now let's see what are the few more topics which you can see and which you can prepare regarding your quantitative aptitude as well as verbal ability. Okay, so coming to the quantitative aptitude, please concentrate on number system. So these are the important topics which are common for each and every exam. Okay, coming to quantitative aptitude, verbal ability, English as well as logical reasoning, I'm giving important topics for all the exams. Okay, coming to Gram Sachivalayam exams, like there are many exams in Gram Sachivalayam, many posts, right? So for each and every post, all these important topics will be applicable. Okay, so this is not for any particular post, this is for entire post. Okay, all the posts. Okay, so in later videos I will tell you the important topics for each and every post separately. Okay, so coming to quantitative aptitude, please concentrate on number system. Very basic and very easy questions will be asked coming to the quantitative aptitude from number system. Please concentrate on number system and then concentrate on percentages. Okay, so coming to quantitative aptitude, few important formulae, if you remember, you can solve any kind of questions. Okay, you need not worry at all. Follow the standard books because you have only 7 weeks, 7 days, that is just 1 week left for your exam. So please concentrate on these topics, like which I am going to tell you coming to quantitative aptitude. And also don't forget to remember the formulae, which will be helpful for you in solving the questions within less time. Okay, so coming to quantitative aptitude, first topic, very important topic, is number system, and then percentages, and then profit and loss. It is very easy and important. Okay, then interest, that is simple interest as well as compound interest. And then please concentrate on averages. Time and distance means how much time will a person take to reach so and so distance, okay, or to cross so and so distance. So such kind of questions will be asked. So you need to concentrate mostly on time and distance, because questions from these time and distance will be a bit tough. Okay, so then time and work is very important. And then please concentrate on probability and permutation and combination. These are the few important topics coming to quantitative aptitude. Now let's see what you can prepare coming to the verbal ability. Okay, verbal ability means you need to concentrate on sentence improvement. Means there will they'll give you a sentence where there will be few mistakes in the sentence, or few words you can add, you need to add in the sentence. So it is nothing but you need to improve the sentence. Okay, so this is called the sentence improvement. Okay, so now coming to the most important topics coming to the verbal ability, please concentrate on sentence improvement. Reading comprehension is nothing but they'll give you a paragraph, okay, or a passage from which you need to search answers. Okay, a few questions will be asked directly, few questions will be asked indirectly, few questions will be asked in such a way that you should have the knowledge of entire paragraph which they gave you. So reading comprehension is one of the most important topic where you can easily score more than 8 marks. Okay, and coming to reading comprehension, most of the students will be wasting time in this particular reading comprehension. Manage your time, don't waste your time in reading the paragraph again and again. First read the questions and then read the paragraph. That is in for reading comprehension, it saves a lot of time. Okay, and then please concentrate on close test. It is also very important. And then sentence rearrangement. Okay, there'll be, it's like para jumbles, I can tell you. So you just need to rearrange the given sentences in the correct pattern or in the correct way. Okay, and then please concentrate on synonyms and antonyms. Antonyms are nothing but opposites. Synonyms are nothing but meanings. So coming to synonyms, they'll give you a word and they'll ask you to find the synonym of the word. Okay, means you need to find the meaning of the word. Coming to antonyms, they'll give you a word, you need to find the opposite of the word, which is also called as antonym. Okay, so the more you practice coming to the synonyms and antonyms, the more marks you can easily get. Okay, so coming to the logical reasoning, quantitative aptitude and verbal ability, which I've told you, these three are very important in order to pass in the part A exam of grammar sachivalayam post. Okay, so the all these three are common for all the posts. Okay, so the important topics which I've told you for aptitude and ability, that is verbal ability as well as the reasoning, these three topics are common important topics for all the exams in grammar sachivalayam, for grammar sachivalayam post. Now let's see how can you easily crack part B of this exam. Okay, so part B, coming to the part B, the preparation will be different for different posts. Okay, so let's see for each and every post. Okay, so coming to the part B, what you need to do is, first you have to, part A we have already covered. Now coming to the part B, what you need to do is, first coming to the village agriculture assistant. Okay, this is grade 2. For this particular exam, what you need to do is, let's see what are the important topics. Coming to the part B paper, what you need to do is, please concentrate on crop production. Okay, all the questions will be asked regarding agriculture and crops and also soil erosions and all. And they'll also ask you questions regarding how can you improve the crops and how can you develop the crop system and all. And they'll also ask you watershed management, how to manage the water for entire crops. So such kind of questions will be asked. Please concentrate on these kind of topics. And then they'll ask you the questions regarding the seed technology, basics of the seed technology, and how can you improvise the technologies regarding the harvesting. So such kind of questions will be asked coming to the part B for agriculture exam. So now let's see for animal husbandry assistant part B. Okay, so coming to the animal husbandry part B, what you need to do is, first please concentrate on animal system. Okay, their entire system, body system, bones, digestive system, and all. Okay, those are very important. and then please concentrate on what are the various diseases or infections which you can prevent. Okay, what are the various infections, diseases you can prevent coming to animals? Okay, and then please concentrate on pharmacy, such as veterinary pharmacy, such as what are the standards you will follow in order to improvise the drug manufacturing or related to the drugs. And then you need to concentrate on the basic fundamentals of detection of heat in livestock, and how you can help out them from the heat in the livestock. So such kind of topics will be asked coming to the part B. And then medicines, okay? So how can you protect them? How can you protect their health? How can you reduce their animal infections? How you can reduce the causes of infections? So such kind of related questions will be asked, and also respiratory system questions which are related to their skin diseases and all. So now let's see for ANM and MPHAF grade 3 part B. Okay, so coming to part B of this particular exam, concentrate mostly on anatomy and physiology. These two are very important in order to crack the exam. And next important topic is, please concentrate on emergency nursing and first aid. It is also very important. And then you need to see what is the health nursing, family planning welfare, and maternity nursing, the basic questions. And then what are the basic medicines which you can use for first aid, and what are the health problems, and also what are the different diseases. So such kind of easy questions will be asked. Coming to the fisheries, for this particular post, coming to the part B, please concentrate on the principles of taxonomy, and what are the different types of fishes, and what is the classification of the fishes, and also the topics such as what is inland fish, seed forms and managements, and also how can you protect the fishes, and what is ecology of ponds, reservoirs, rivers. So such kind of questions will be mostly asked coming to this particular fishery post. And coming to the other important topics, you need to concentrate on what is water and soil management, how we can manage the water as well as the soil, and what is seed rearing, what is breeding and hatchery management of fresh water, and such kind of basic questions will be asked. And also how you can control the pollution in the water, how you can take the measures in order to reduce the pollution in the water, rivers and reservoirs. So such kind of questions will be most commonly asked. What they wanted to know is, they'll be asking questions in such a type that to test your knowledge in the fisheries, to test your concern for marine creatures. So please concentrate on the important topics which I've told you. And coming to the fishery, we have just done with discussing the important topics. Now coming to village horticulture assistants, for part B, please concentrate on what are the different horticulture crops, and what is the climate that supports the horticulture crops, and what is training and pruning, and what are the remedies for unfruitfulness. And a few more important topics are, what is coal crops, COLE, okay, coal crops, and what are bulbs, and what is soil formation, soil structure, and soil profile, the basic questions regarding the all the soil erosions and all. And also, please concentrate on the questions such as what is advantage and disadvantage of the farm power. Okay, the farm power is one of the most important topic, and please concentrate on primary and secondary tillage. Okay, and what is plough? What are the other procedures which you can follow for horticulture, and what are construction features and uses in horticulture? And few more important topics are what are the different species, and what are manures, and what are fertilizers. So most common questions which they asked, which they're going to ask you, is what is bulky organic manures, what are the procedures to plow, and you know, what is concentrated organic measures. So such kind of basic questions they're going to ask for this particular post. Okay, now let's see what are the part B important topics which they are going to ask you for village Mahila police and women and child welfare assistant. Okay, so coming to part B, what you need to do is concentrate on the topics such as rights and issues. Okay, how you can protect children with their rights, how you can protect women with their rights, and what are the actions to be taken when there is something against happened for a child or a woman. And then you need to have the complete knowledge about the rights and justice, as well as the administrative rules regarding Andhra Pradesh, okay, which are at present working as a law under the Andhra Pradesh government. Okay, and then what you need to do is please concentrate on the topics such as cultural and political problems, and what are the economic and social problems against the women, and also how you can protect the justice, which are like, you know, anti-justice policies which are happening against women. So basic questions they'll be asked, and they may also ask you like so and so particular law when it was introduced. Okay, so in like, you know, this particular right of law when it was introduced, so please concentrate on the history, such as the rules when they are introduced, at what time they are introduced, and the reason behind the rules. Go in detail coming to the legal justice. Okay, and now let's see few more posts. Coming to the panchayat secretariat and digital assistant, coming to the part B, you need to concentrate on data structures. Coming to data structures, please concentrate on stack, queue, linked list, trees. Okay, trees, binary search trees, and they may ask you to traversal like a particular question. They may ask you anything. Okay, so go in depth for the subjects such as data structures and all. And coming to the questions, they may also ask you to search or sort a particular pattern. Okay, for example, they'll give you a series. They'll ask you to search a particular number from the series, or they may ask you to sort the numbers in either ascending order or in descending order. So practice well. Okay, so coming to other important topics, coming to database management system, you need to concentrate mostly on the architecture of database management system, and also normal forms 1NF, 2NF, BCNF, 3NF. They're always very important, and you should be able able to create a table, manipulate the table, and you should be thorough with the DDL, DCL, DML queries. Okay, you should be very thorough with the queries and how to create a table, how to view a table, the basic queries, okay, you need not worry at all. So coming to the operating system, please concentrate on different types on concepts of operating system, such as what is the structure of operating system, what are the uses of operating system and all, and also process handling, process management and all, and how you will manage your the memory and all. Okay, so coming to the programming languages, you should be thorough with the C language. Coming to the C language, go with the basic questions such as history of C language, loops, arrays and all. So coming to the OOPs concepts, the four concepts, okay, polymorphism, inheritance, data and like encapsulation, the basic concepts such as what is a class, what are objects. So these kind of questions are very, very, very important. So coming to the computer network, you should have the complete knowledge with the, about the different protocols, different layers and all. So that's it. If you're thorough with these particular topics, you can happily and easily crack this particular exam. Okay. So coming to the few more posts, now let's see the posts regarding engineering assistant. Coming to the engineering assistant, you should be really good with the basics of your engineering subjects. Okay, you should have the complete knowledge about engineering mechanics, such as what is the equilibrium of forces, what is center of gravity and all, and also what is center of mass, the basic questions, and moment of inertia and fluid mechanisms, very important. And also you should be very good with the production technology. So these are very important topics coming to engineering subject. Now let's see what are the most important topics for village revenue officer post. Coming to the village revenue officer post, you should be very good with the drawing. Okay, you should have very good skills and you should be really good at your numbering and figuring skills. Like you should have a good memory in order to remember many numbers, many figures. Okay, figures in the sense the numbers, okay, the series of the numbers. And then you should be really good with the conventional signs and symbols as per IS code for engineering drawing and building drawing. It's very important for you people. And then be really confident with the pipeline systems, pipeline joint drainage works, manholes. You should have complete knowledge about surveying of different kind of buildings and also plotting and all. So you should also be good at drawing the contours and calculating different levels of things, and you should have good knowledge about different types of irrigation structures. So these are the most important topics coming to the village revenue officer post. And coming to the village surveyor grade 3, the most important topics coming to the part B is, you should have very good knowledge about different times or types of stone joints and what are the drawing plans and elevation systems and all regarding the soil and solids and surfaces. Be very good with surveying the building sites with chains, and also handling the different levels of the instrument as well as pipelines of joint drainage system, and also types of divided joints and steel section, standard steel section. So these are the most important topics coming to this particular post. And last but not least, coming to the welfare and education assistant, you should be really good with the topics such as issues of the rights. You should have complete knowledge about the different rights, different laws, different rules, and also the questions will be asked regarding the different schemes which the government of Andhra Pradesh has announced recently, and also be sure with the politics which are happening in the recent past. And also you should have very good knowledge on economy and socio planning of Andhra Pradesh in India, and you should have the complete knowledge about the different schemes of government and what are the different justice and what are the different laws which are introduced for women empowerment and women justice. So these are the few important topics which will be asked in the exam. Hope I covered each and every particular post and each and every particular exam for Grammar Sachivalayam. Hope you found this video useful. Now let's see what are the most important tips which you can which helps you to score more marks, and you can easily pass in the exam. Tip one is practice part A more, okay? Because coming to part A, you need to concentrate on three different sections, such as general aptitude, that is quantitative aptitude, verbal ability and reasoning, which is very important. Okay, so please concentrate on these. Mostly coming to the part B, the topics whichever I told you as important, please concentrate on them. And also the second tip is, coming to the exam, it's very important for you to manage the time. Okay, time management is one of the most important criteria which can easily help you to score more marks. Okay, and the third tip is there are only 7 days, that is, there's only 1 week left for your exam. Instead of starting new topics, start revising the existing topics which you have already learned. And fourth important topic is, coming to the quantitative aptitude, please don't forget to revise the important formulae again and again. Okay, make the short notes of entire formulae coming to the quantitative aptitude, and keep revising it twice a day every time, because these particular formulae will help you to solve quantitative aptitude questions within less time, because you have very limited time for this particular exam. And there is also negative marking, so make sure don't take risk of guess marking the answers, or you know, until unless you are unable to cross the minimum cutoff, then it's your personal choice to take the risk. Else I'll suggest you not to take any risk of guess marking or risk taking by guessing the answers. So and few more important tips are, please be at the exam center at least before 1 hour without fail, okay? And be confident. With confidence you can easily crack this exam. Hard work also matters. Please work hard. You just have very less time for this particular exam, and there are lakhs of people awaiting to attempt this exam. So I wish all the very best for all the students and all the people who are going to attend this exam, and I pray that all of you should be placed for the particular post for which you are writing the exam. All the very best. Be confident. Don't waste your time. Work hard. Revise, revise, revise. All the very best for your exam. Thanks for watching this video.